Visit arborday.org. See how together we can plant our future.
View, a look at some of the news of note with Michael Badger from Champaign-Urbana, Illinois.
Hi, I'm Michael Badger presenting with the Champaign County Crime Stoppers Bulletin. The Champaign police are seeking information regarding an attempted armed robbery that occurred on Saturday, November 13th, at the Circle K gas station located at 601 North Neal Street, Champaign. An employee reported that a subject entered the store twice and removed products from the freezer, stating he would come back later to purchase them. The third time he entered the business, he was holding a knife in his hand and approached the window at the cash register area, yelling at the employee. The employee was able to secure and lock the window. The suspect then dropped the knife and fled the area northbound on foot. No one was injured in the incident and no items were taken. The suspect is described as a black male in his early 30s, 6'0" tall, medium build, with brown eyes and black hair and braids. He was wearing a black stocking cap, black jacket, and black pants. If you have any information regarding the suspect's identity and/or location, call Crime Stoppers at 217-373-TIPS or 217-373-8477. Information can also be sent by anonymous web tip by going to www.373tips.com, www.373tips.com, or by sending an anonymous cell phone text to the following: tip 397 plus the information to CRIMES or 274637. The information you provide is confidential. You do not have to give your name or appear in court. Crime Stoppers will pay a reward if the information you provide leads to an arrest for this crime. Cash rewards are also paid for information on other felony crimes or fugitives in the Champaign County area. I'm Michael Badger. This has been your Crime Stoppers of Champaign County report. Hello and welcome to News View. Tonight's top story is of President Hu of China is going to be in Chicago, or maybe is in Chicago by now, Chicago, Illinois, for meetings and talks. And in other news, the FBI has arrested 100 suspects from the mafia in New York City. This according to the Associated Press and on Long Island, they have they have sentenced John Sonny Franzese, age 93, to 8 years in prison for extorting Manhattan strip clubs and a pizzeria on Long Island. Federal prosecutors wanted 12 years of jail for the underboss of the Colombo crime family. An FBI agent testified that Franzese bragged about killing 60 people over the years and once contemplated hitting on his own son for cooperating with the government. And they say that this is the biggest mafia bust in New York history. And in other news, a report about Congresswoman Representative Gabrielle Giffords is, according to the doctor, standing up and using an iPad. So she is with assistance standing up, and she's making great recovery so far. And of course, she was one of the victims where six bystanders, a federal judge, a 9-year-old girl were killed and 14 others wounded in a shooting by a Jared Loughner a couple weeks ago. And in other news, according to the Kansas City Star, Lindsay Jacobevis from Vermont led the U.S. Winning her third career world championship gold in the USA. She landed on 3 of 6 snowboard cross medals Tuesday in Monmolia, Spain. And the Olympic silver medalist was right out of the gate, hitting all her starts. And she tied with the late Karen Ruby of France for the most world championship victories with 3 medals. Australia's man in the men's Australia World Cup leader Alex Pullen was crowned champion while the U.S. swept second and third. The two-time Olympic champion Westcott earned his 4th career world championship medal, the most of any SBX rider, and at the X Games, he was a 6-time X Games champ, Holland, who picked up his 2nd bronze. And in other news, in West Philadelphia, a doctor killed 7 babies with scissors after botching their abortions. The doctor's clinic was described as a filthy, foul-smelling house of horrors, quote-unquote, that was overlooked for years by regulators, and he was charged on Wednesday with murder and accused of delivering 7 babies alive, then using scissors to kill them. Gosnell, age 69, was arrested and charged with 8 counts of murder in all. 9 of his employees, including his wife, a cosmetologist who authorities say performed abortions, also were charged. This is in West Philadelphia, thanks to WPVI TV6 News. In other news, Jimmy John's, the sandwich company whose corporate headquarters are currently in Champaign, Illinois, might leave the state due to a rise in taxes and maybe other reasons. We're not sure, but they might move out of Illinois because of the tax hikes that Jimmy John's, and we've had reports about Jimmy John's and salmonella and how they've switched to different sprouts before. And thank you for watching NewsView. If you have any comments, questions, or complaints, you can email me at newsview@email.com. That's the address. That's newsview@email.com. And that's how you can reach me with any tips, news tips, stories, ideas for the show, a program here. And we'll come back for more here on NewsView after this. And now welcome to your NewsView weather forecast for Champaign, Urbana, and the surrounding areas. Friday night, a low of 6 degrees Fahrenheit should be what we'll have with snow. As for Saturday, a high temperature should reach 23 degrees Fahrenheit with more snow. And Saturday night, a low temperature of 11 degrees Fahrenheit with mostly cloudy skies and a chance of snow. And for your Sunday, a high temperature of 21 degrees Fahrenheit with snow possible. And for Sunday night, a low temperature of 13 degrees Fahrenheit and cloudy skies. Thanks for watching NewsView. Stay tuned for the rest of NewsView right here on UPTV and YouTube.